Okay, so next exercise 12. So in this one, we have a non-empty set given to us, G, and we are given an associative product on G, which, under which G is also closed. And two additional conditions are given, which look somewhat like the existence of identity and existence of inverse in our ordinary definition of a group. However, you can see if you look closely, E is an element in G such that A dot E is equal to A for all A in G. This does not say that E is an identity, because for E to be an identity, not only should A dot E be equal to A, but E dot A should also be equal to A. Okay, so E can be called a right identity. Just like that, every element A in G has a right inverse YA. That's what the second condition says, where YA, of course, denotes the fact that this element depends on A. That's why we are using a notation like this. But in spite of this half conditions, if you can say, call them, still G, this system G will turn out to be a group. That's what we have to prove. So since already it's given that G is closed and under the operation, and the operation is associative, and already we have an identity like element and inverse like elements, so why not try to show that E is actually an identity element and YA actually acts as an inverse of A. That's what we are going to do precisely. So let's see how that can be done. Let A belonging to G be any element. Our aim, first of all, is to show that E dot A is also equal to A. So we denote it by some symbol. Let B be the element E dot A. Okay. Then we start off like this. A dot YA is equal to E. This is just coming from the second condition, condition B. Now, E can be written as E dot E. This you get if you replace A by E. If you replace A with E, then you get E dot E. Keep in mind that the calculations we are now going through, they look like group calculations. However, we don't have a group. We have to prove that the system is a group. So you should not end up inadvertently using some group property. If you do that somewhere unknowingly, then that will be a mistake, because G is not a group. So we cannot use any group property. All we can use are these things, what is given to us. So far we have done that. Okay, now in place of E, we can write YA dot YYA. What have we done here? We have used condition B here with the element YA in place of A, because YA is after all also an element of G. So it will also have a right inverse, and that will be denoted by Y of YA according to this notation. Now we can use the associative law, which however, by the way, is available, not because G is a group, no. It's given that the operation is associative, that's why. So this is equal to E dot YA dot Y of A. Okay, now am I missing something? A dot YA or Okay, I think I have written the wrong thing. Excuse me. This is not. Okay, I should not have written YA here. Here I should have A dot YA. Okay, because after all A dot YA is also equal to E. That calculation what I have written, that comes next. Now we are going to use the associative law. E dot A dot YA. And this is equal to E dot A is B. We are calling it by B. So B dot YA. Okay. Hence, should we start with B or start with A? I think it's better to start with A, although I have written here B. Let us see. A can be written as A dot E. That is coming from here. Okay. Now, this is where we write YA dot YYA. Because that will also be E. And then use the associative law. Okay, so far it's working. Now, in place of A dot YA, we can write B dot YA because these two have been proved to be equal. We again use the associative law. And this will be equal to E, and that is equal to B. Okay, so what have we shown? We have shown that B is actually equal to A. Thus, so B is E dot A, that is equal to A. So we not only have A dot E equal to A, we have E dot A is also equal to A. And keep in mind that A is any element in G. So E actually is an identity. Next, just like this one, now you know what we have to do here. We have to show that YA dot A is equal to E. So next, let us name it something. Let's C denote YA dot A. Okay. Here we start with C straight away. Start with C straight away. First of all, we have to show something else. Then, YA is equal to YA dot E. Okay. Because I am coming from here. In place of A, I have YA. Right. Then in place of E, we can write A dot YA from the condition B. And then use the associative law dot YA. Now YA dot A is C. So we have C dot YA So we have proved that YA is equal to C dot YA. This implies C. Okay, now we can start with C. C is equal to C dot E. Taking C here in place of A, we get C equal to C dot E. Now in place of E, we take YA dot YYA. Just like that calculation. And then use the associative law. C dot YA dot YYA. From above, we have C dot YA equal to YA. So YA dot YYA. And this again is equal to E. So C is nothing but E. So YA dot A is equal to E. So YA dot A is equal to E, and A dot YA is also equal to E. This shows that YA acts as an inverse of A. Hence G is a group under the given operation. Where E acts as an identity and YA acts as an inverse of A in G. This completes the solution. Okay, next, the 13th one. So in short, what we have proved now is that if you have a system where there is an associative operation with respect to which the underlying set is closed, and if there is a right identity and a right inverse to every element, then the system is a group. Now in exercise 13, prove by an example that the conclusion of exercise 12 is false. If we assume instead slightly different conditions, there exists an E belonging to G such that A dot E is equal to A for all A in G. This is just condition A, no change. E is a right identity. However, condition B prime is not what condition B was. For every or given a same thing for every A belonging to G, there exists YA belonging to G such that YA dot A is equal to E. So unlike condition B that we had in the previous exercise, here YA is a left inverse, it's not a right inverse. Okay, so what do we have to do here actually? We have to prove that under these conditions, it's not guaranteed that the system is a group. So that means we have to produce an example where all these things are true, but the system is not a group. And that's what we are going to do precisely to solve this exercise. We can start the solution from here itself. Consider the three element set G consisting of three elements. What these elements are, that we don't care. Okay, they are just some three elements. And an operation dot on G defined as follows. A dot A dot B. Keep in mind that defining an operation means we have to define it for every possible pair of elements. And A dot C are all defined to be equal to A. B dot A, B dot B, and B dot C are all defined to be equal to B, and C dot A, C dot B, and C dot C are all defined to be equal to C. Okay. Clearly, G is closed under dot. Okay, that is obvious, because whatever operation we are performing, ultimately we are ending up with the elements in G. So G is closed under the operation. Next, we want to see that the operation is associative. Now, it may seem like a daunting task. Usually it is, to show that an operation is associative. You have to consider products which look like this. And show that these two are equal, where in place of X, Y, and Z, any of these elements can appear. So naturally, there will be many cases. However, luckily in our case, the operation has been defined in such a way that this job will be highly reduced. Let us see what we mean by that. We don't have to actually look at all the things. Note from the B definition of the operation dot above that x dot y is equal to x for all x and y in G. Is that the case? You see, what this equation is saying is that the result is just the factor on the first factor. Actually, that is the case. You see, here the result is constantly A, irrespective of what the second factor is. Here on this line, the result is constantly B, here it is constantly C. So this is a fact about this operation. Let x, y and z be any three elements in G. Then what about this? Using this property, x dot y will be equal to x, but since in place of y we can take any element, so we can take z also, so that is also equal to x. And what about x dot y dot z? You can write x directly here, because here the first factor is x. So in place of y dot z, of course we will have either A or B or C, it does not matter. Ultimately we are going to have x. That is, this is equal to this. So the operation is associative. So we now have at least a system where we have a set and a binary operation, such that the set is closed with respect to the operation and the operation is associative. What else we need now? We need a right identity and a left inverse for every element. Note that a right identity, A dot A is equal to A, B dot A is equal to B, and C dot A is equal to C. Hence, A plays the role of E in condition A prime. So A acts as a right identity. Okay, now we look for left inverse. So we now need a YA for, think of X here, YX dot X must be equal to A for every X in G. If we have A in place of X, for YA we can of course choose A, because A dot A is A, right? Keep in mind that this A is fixed, this is our identity. This may change. If we have B here, then what can be taken in place of A? I mean yx. Again, a can be taken because a dot b is equal to a. If we have c in place of x, then also we can take a. So actually, this is ya as well as yb as well as yc. Moreover, YA equal to YB equal to YC equal to A plays the role of, okay, we cannot, it doesn't sound right. We should not write it like this. Moreover, note that A dot A is equal to A, B dot A is equal to A. Oh, sorry, I have written just the opposite thing. A dot B is equal to A and A dot C is equal to A. So we can take YA equal to YB equal to YC equal to A. Okay, that is condition B prime is true. Okay, now the question is the resulting, what is our aim? We have now found an example in which all the things given in the exercise, in this exercise, are true, but we have to prove that G is not a group. But G is not a group under the operation dot because A dot B is equal to A dot C, but B is not equal to C. Why does this say that G is not a group? Note that in a group, we have left cancellation law. So if this equation is true, and if this system had been a group, we should have had B equal to C, because we should have been able to apply the left cancellation law to cancel A from both sides. But that is not the case. B and C are two different elements. So the system, whatever it is, it cannot be a group. So this shows that the, if we have all the things that is a non-empty set closed under an associative operation, but we have a right identity and a left inverse for every element, then the system is not necessarily a group. We should have right identity and right inverse. Okay, so here the solution ends. Then we have another something like this. Exercise 40. Suppose A non-empty finite set. Okay, now we are given finiteness. A non-empty finite set G is closed under an associative operation. Under an associative operation or associative product, same thing. They have written product, we are writing operation. Nothing changes. And that both cancellation laws hold in G. Prove that G must be a group. Okay, so the beginning is somewhat like what we had here or in the previous exercise, I mean the one before this. We still have a non-empty set G closed under an associative operation. So these are two conditions. G is closed under the operation and the operation is associative. But further, it is also given that G is finite and both the left and right cancellation laws are true in G. Then we have to prove that G is a group. So here the fact that this system is a group comes not only from the fact that the cancellation laws hold in G, but also from the finiteness of G. That is also very important. We will see why finiteness is important soon. So let's see the solution to this one. Since G is given to be finite, we can enlist its element. Let G be equal to A1, A2, An, where n is some positive integer. Okay, now keep in mind that since G is given to be non-empty, so n will be a positive integer. If G is empty, we don't have anything to do with that. So let G is this. Okay, now consider an arbitrary element A in G, right? Consider an arbitrary element. Then again I have to write consider. It won't sound nice. Let me change the language a bit. Let A belonging to G be any element . Consider the elements A dot A1 comma A dot A2 A dot AN, where we are assuming that the operation that is there in this system, that is denoted by dot. Okay. From the left cancellation law, it follows can write like this. they are related. From the left cancellation law, it follows that these elements are all distinct why? Because you see, if you have, say, for example, a1 equal to a3, suppose you had something like this, that two elements are equal in this list, then since we have left cancellation law, we can cancel a from both sides to have a1 equal to a3, which is actually not true because these are all distinct elements. So our the place from where we started, that is wrong. That means no two elements in this list, no two symbols in this list are the same symbol or are the same thing. So here we have come across n distinct elements, but after all, G is closed under this operation. So all these elements have to be in G, which, by the way, has n elements. So these must be the n elements in G in some order, since these elements belong to G.